Ernesto Che Guevara was born on June 14, 1928, Rosario, Argentina. The mother of Che Guevara, Celia de la Serna, was a purebred Argentine aristocrat, descended from the Spanish nobility. The father of Che Guevara, Ernesto Guevara Lynch, was tall and handsome. He belonged by birth to the elite of the Argentinian society. Che Guevara's father bought 200 hectares of jungle along the coast of Paraná to create mate plantations, and at the earliest age of 1 year lived near this plantation. From a young age, Ernesto showed chronic asthma, and even moving to the resort town of Alta, Groucho did not help to cope with it. In 1945, the serious side of Ernesto's personality began to unfold. His interest was attracted to philosophy. Ernesto reads and quotes Hitler, Marx, Engels and Lenin. In 1947, Ernesto entered the medical faculty of the University of Buenos Aires. The family believed that this decision was caused by his worries about the illness and death of his grandmother. Ernesto saw that modern medicine could not ease her torment. Buenos Aires became only a springboard for Ernesto to expand its geographical horizons. Ernesto began to hitchhike. According to Ernesto, the appearance of Argentina as a state boiled down to a magnificent facade, which hid the true soul of the country, out back of the country. Ernesto, along with his friend Alberto Granado, began to prepare for an annual trip across the South American continent, and this trip began on January 4, 1952, when he decided to visit his beloved girlfriend Sishina before the trip. In 1954, Guevara ended up in Guatemala, and it was then that for the first time in his correspondence ideological convictions were voiced. My life provided me with a sea of ready-made answers, until I boldly left everything that was given to me. I was given the opportunity to drive through the United Fruit Holdings and became entrenched in the thought of how terrible these capitalist octopuses are. In Guatemala, I will perfect to perfection all those qualities that are necessary for a despicable revolutionary. Ernesto met his 26th birthday without the shame and glory that he expected to receive in Guatemala. 2 days after the birthday of Che Guevara, the Americans began to bomb the territory of Guatemala, but Ernesto was not part of the small liberation army of Guatemala, consisting of 400 people led by Castal Armas. Ernesto, in search of new sensations, spent in Mexico, taking part in mountain climbing. So he climbed the snowy peak of Mount Popocatépetl, 5,400 meters. That summer 1955, Ernesto wrote in his diary, "A politically important event is a meeting with Fidel Castro, a Cuban revolutionary, a young, smart, very confident man who is distinguished by rare courage. I think mutual sympathy arose between us." Fidel Castro's revolution was to begin in 1956, by the great day that the revolution would triumph. Ernesto wanted to study political and economic theory properly. Guevara plunged into the study of economics and began to study the works of Adam Smith, Keynes and other economists, to study Mao Zedong and Soviet books. In addition, he modestly attended the meeting of the Mexican Communist Party. In one of the first skirmishes after landing in Cuba, Che Guevara was seriously wounded in the neck. After that, he decided that he was mortally wounded and lay on his back, preparing for an imminent death. Crossing to Cuba has become a nightmare. The road to Cuba took a full 7 days, instead of 5. They were spotted by a Cuban Coast Guard boat and eventually ran aground, making their arrival in Cuba more likely a shipwreck than a landing. Batista's troops executed without delay the many captured, including the wounded and those who surrendered themselves. Of the 82 people who arrived at Granmi, only 22 people eventually connected in the Sierra Maestra Mountains. Spreading over 100 miles along almost the entire southeastern tip of Cuba, the Sierra Maestra mountain target forms a natural barrier between the sea and fertile lands. In these parts there were only a few small towns and villages inhabited by about 60,000 peasants who were struggling to get their own bread. They were called guerrilla. The poverty of Guevara Sierra Maestra's life sharply contrasted with the lifestyle of the local landowners, and most of the inhabitants of the cities of the province of Oriental. At that time, Fidel and his people were strangers on this earth. During January 1957, postants roamed the Sierra Maestra, recruiting new volunteers and constantly encountering cases of betrayal and desertion. ɽtʃe increasingly turned into a desperate and bold fighter, guerrilla. So, Ernesto Guevara was in the war, where he was led by a desire to create a revolution. He crossed an invisible border and entered into an area where life can be taken away in the name of an ideal and where the end justifies the means. Over the next 9 months, the rebels, led by Castro and ɽtʃe Guevara, fought a desperate struggle in the Sierra Maestra Mountains, experiencing a constant lack of food, weapons, and health. By October alone, the position of the rebel army in Orient began to improve and it now numbered about 800 people. However, for a start it was necessary to win the war. In Las Villas, a strategically important province that the rebel hoped for, ɽtʃe finally managed to get what he wanted. In December 1958, ɽtʃe Guevara met his future wife Aleida March. Aleida was not afraid of anything, she was delivering weapons and bombs all over the province, hiding them under long skirts in the fashion of the 50s. So, after a two-year grueling struggle with the regime, Batista, Fidel Castro and ɽtʃe Guevara could celebrate the victory in the harbor in January 1959. ɽtʃe was the second man of the revolution, but nevertheless Fidel sent him to a secondary position in La Cabana for the important work of cleaning the old army and administering revolutionary justice to the traitors, Cervato and Batista war criminals.
Who could be significando siempre lo mismo?
On January 27, 1959, a speech was made at a forum in Harbor ɽtʃe called The Social Program of the Rebel Army. ɽtʃe disclosed his idea of the Continental Revolution, which not only challenged the general communist theory of the struggle of the masses under the leadership of the party, but also called for armed struggle throughout the hemisphere. We have proved that a small group of determined people can defeat the regular army and finally defeat it. This is the main lesson. The revolution sentenced Latin American tyrants because they are the same enemies of popular regimes as foreign monopolistic enterprises. Since February 1960, ɽtʃe Guevara began to have regular contacts with representatives of the ASR intelligence, including Leonov. The beginning of the work of ɽtʃe Guevara as the Minister of Industry of Cuban era was somewhat crumpled, but then everything was fine. At the end of 1959, a significant part of Cuban industry was privately owned, and ɽtʃe was left with only a few small factories abandoned by the owners or confiscated from the owners, garnished with ties to the Batista. ɽtʃe loved to joke about how he got the post of president of the National Bank of Cuba. At a cabinet meeting, Fidel said he needed a good economist. to Fidel's surprise, Che raised his hand. Castro, Che, I did not think you were an economist. Che replies, but I heard that you need a good communist. On March 4, 1960, the French cargo ship Cuba exploded in the port of Havana. During the second explosion, both Fidel Castro and Che Guevara nearly died, and after that Castro proclaimed a new military motto, a famous homeland or death. After that, Cuba resumed diplomatic relations with Moscow and Che Guevara was invited by Nikita Khrushchev to the ˈtʃe on November 7, 1960, where he stood on the podium with Khrushchev and watched the military parade. Che made his first trip to the countries of the communist bloc. Within 2 months he visited Prague, Moscow, Leningrad, Stalingrad, Irkutsk, Beijing, Shanghai, Finland and Berlin. The main purpose of Che's trip was to agree on the sale of that part of the Cuban crop that had not yet been sold. On February 24, 1961, an attempt was made on Che. Che refused the salary due to him as the president of the National Bank and refused the salary of the Minister of Industry of Cuba. Guevara's program, called the Communist Competition, was based on the idea that giving his work for the benefit of society, without thinking of remuneration, a person takes an important step towards the formation of a true communist consciousness. In 1966, with the help of Fidel, Che began to prepare the way for a new enterprise for the sake of a common cause. He hoped to eventually be in Argentina, but the conditions for this had to be prepared in Bolivia. When the uprising in Argentina is in full swing, he will leave Bolivia and take command. Analyzing the reasons for his defeat in the Congo, Che acknowledged that one of his fateful mistakes was blackmailed by personal presence when he appeared among the Congolese rebels and took over. This aroused hostility and suspicion on the part of local leaders. Che vowed not to make this mistake again, and yet, having flown to Bolivia in November 1966, he repeated his Congolese blackmail one by one, reappearing on foreign territory without invitation. This time his mistake will be truly fatal. And the Bolivian Revolution of Che ended with his death on October 9, 1967 in Valgrande until now, in Valgrande, on the wall of the telephone exchange, you can see graffiti in Spanish with the inscription, Che, you'll live than they wanted. This